Hi kids, today we are going to learn Standard 4 Social Study Lesson 2 Sources of History. The key concept of this lesson are what are sources, historian and archaeologist, literary and archaeological sources, oral history and preservation of sources. Before we start to learn about the sources of history, let us know what is history. History is a subject which helps us to study about the past. And to study all this, we need some document or proof which will tell us about the past. So there are various documents we need to study when we are studying about the past. And these sources of history are told us by the historians who tells about the history. They are like the detectives. They look around for all the clues and find out all the events that happened in a chronological order. Digging done by the archaeologists help us to know about the past because at many places ancient remains are revealed by removing layers of soil over them one at a time. Cooking pots, rubbish pit tell us what people ate. Let us look at these sources in details. These sources put under three heads: the literary sources, the archaeological sources and the oral sources. Now let us come to know about the literary sources. Literary sources are written sources which includes books, manuscripts, written records or documents and letters. These are the one of the most reliable and useful sources of history. Archaeological sources. Archaeological sources include the coins, artifacts and the monuments. Now artifacts and inscription. Historians look around for objects that will tell them about the past. And these objects they study carefully and find out more facts related to this object. And these objects are called the artifacts. Example, pottery, painting, utensils, tools and weapons. Monuments tell us a lot about the period in which they were built. They tell us about the lifestyle, social life, religious beliefs, culture and also the advancement in science during that period. Monuments are thus a link between the past and the present. Coins. Coins are another valuable source of information. They tell us about the ruling period of a king, the economy of the kingdom, and the business or trade relation with other countries. Coins can also give accurate information like the year to which they belong or about the ruler of that time. There are many people in the past who did not write in their histories in books. They told stories, poems and songs to their generation in the form of history and these are called oral sources of history. Again, we can divide these sources into two types. One is the primary sources and one is the secondary sources. Primary like the coins, monument of a period and secondary like the records, accounts or document written much later. Preservation of sources. We know by now that we get to know about our history only by these sources and thus it is very important to keep these sources safe and study them carefully. Archaeologists are very careful while digging up the artifacts to prevent any damage to them. After this, they are carefully cleaned, studied and kept in museum under guards. Historians who use the sources have to handle them carefully and make sure not to mark them or damage them. Thank you. Beat number A, fill in the blanks. Question number 1. There are dash types of sources of history. The answer is there are 3 types of sources of history. Question number 2. Dash sources are the most reliable sources of history. The answer is literary sources. Now question number 3. Stories, poems and songs are all dash sources of history. All are oral sources of history. The bit number 4. Dash sources are written much after an event has taken place. Answer. Secondary sources are written much after an event has taken place. Question number 5. Literary sources are kept in state libraries and the answer archives. logical or oral? Yes, the answer is true. B2, question number 2. Paintings are not sources of history. The answer will be false, because paintings are the sources of history. Question number 3. Historians dig up artifacts. False. The archaeologists dig up artifacts. The answer will be false. Now question number 4. Stories, poems and songs are literary sources. No, they are oral sources. So the answer will be false. Primary sources are document and object that belong to the period of our study. Yes, the answer is true. Now come to the maths the followings. In the A part it has given written sources and the answer is archives. The question number 2, artifacts, museum, coins, archaeological sources, Sanchi Stupa, monument, Akbarnama, court account. Now long answers. The first question has given, what are inscriptions? The answer is, artifacts found object with some kind of writing are called inscriptions. Question number 2, how are coins useful as a source of history? And the answer is, coins are useful as a source of history as they tell us about the ruling period, the economy, business or trade relation and provide accurate information of the year and the ruler. Question number 3 has given, discuss the 3 types of sources with example. The answer is, the 3 types of sources are literary sources, example books and manuscripts, archaeological sources, coins and artifacts, oral sources, stories, poems, etc. Now come to the 4th number question, why do we need to preserve sources? And the answer is, we need to preserve sources as we get to know about our history only by these sources. Now come to question number 5, what are primary and secondary sources? The answer is, primary sources are documents or objects that belong to the period of our study like coins and monuments, whereas secondary sources are written much after an event has taken place like records, accounts, etc.